All right, hello and welcome back to episode 3 of Life is Strange, Before the Storm. Now, this is the last episode of the main game. Then we've still got this one, which from the looks of it, my assumption would be it has something to do with the last day that Max was in Arcadia Bay. So, what the fuck? Why did it? Anywho, without further ado, this is Life is Strange Before the Storm, Episode 3, Hell is Empty. Let's get into it.
Previously on Life is Strange Before the Storm, I felt like my dad was lying about something for a while. I didn't know what it was.
Yeah, I know, you started a goddamn fire.
What does that mean?
You forced my hand. This is a consequence of your actions, Chloe. We both agree that the best thing for everyone at this stage is for me to move in.
In a million years, I never thought you'd choose David over me.
Hey!
Black Hole's done with me. I can't go home anymore. Is this junkyard all I've got left?
Drew runs Oxy for Damon. Go to Drew's room, find the money, and I'll meet you to pick it up. Whatever you do, don't open the door.
Oh, I want my fucking money!
Juliet is wailing. That infernal inferno is the culprit, closing down the roads and robbing us of our aerial.
No fucking chance. I swear to thee, we shall fly beyond this isle. The corners of the world are mere prologue. What sayest thou to my most hopeful wish? Yes. Let's leave. For real, if you don't mean this, it's just making me feel like shit that this life you're describing isn't going to happen. What would it take to convince you? Why can't you just
smashing your entire fucking table?
Rachel, that woman you saw, that wasn't my mistress. That was your mother.
Oh shit. Tough fucking shit.
I want to tell you all of it. But are you sure that Chloe should be here for...
Chloe stays.
Of course. In every way that matters, Rose is my wife. And your mother, but the woman you saw at the Overlook, her name is Sarah, your birth mother.
You could have just said biological mom, it would have had the same effect.
Everything I've shielded you from for so long, but the truth can be hard to look at. Is this really something you're ready for?
What is this acid trip? Good lord. Whatever.
Chloe. I'm right here. Good. I need you.
Fucking teenage angst. Alright.
In high school, there was one person everyone adored. Her teachers, her friends. Sarah was everyone's favorite. Every boy wanted to date her. I could barely believe it, but she picked me. Sometimes, I think that's what kept me blind for so long. She was so alive, so passionate about everything. Early on, though, I realized I wasn't enough for her.
What the fuck?
While the rest of us were pursuing college, careers, families, Sarah wasn't looking for any of that. Looking for escape. When Sarah became pregnant, I thought it would solve everything. And it did. For a little while. Becoming your father was the greatest moment of my life. So much love, but I was still blind. However much she loved you then, it wasn't enough.
She's a druggie. Look at that fucking needle under the bed. Oh yeah, shoot that shit up.
I made myself believe that she was still
do it.
A good person. That no matter what happened, she would never do anything to hurt you. Was wrong. Eventually, I saw her for who she really was. A destructive person. Someone who could never be satisfied. Anyone or anything. Even the love of her own daughter. I was desperate. I didn't know what to do. So I made a choice. I was never going to let her harm you again.
That's right, fucker. You ran away. Where's the next one? Oh.
What you saw at the Overlook, Rachel? It's true, we kissed. It was the saddest kiss of my life. It was a kiss goodbye. I told her that I was happy for her. That she felt like she'd gotten her life together. Finally. But she didn't get to just decide one day to be a mother. Not after what she'd done. But after all the people she hurt, all the lives she destroyed, I told her she'd been given the greatest gift in the world, the chance to be your mother. And she squandered it. It pained me to hurt her like that. But I'd do it again, and again,
Such a bitch. You cheated on your wife. Who gives a fuck if she's Rachel's mom or not?
So that was the first time you've seen her or spoken with her in 15 years?
No. I send her money. Every single month. It's our arrangement.
But now she wants to see me?
Yes. But Rachel, it cannot be.
You think you have the right to decide that for her?
When I left Sarah, when I took Rachel away, I truly believe I saved her life. And I will continue to protect her no matter what.
But maybe she's different now. Maybe people change, right?
Maybe so. But consider that for 15 years, she's preferred that money to you.
Rachel. I think I need to lie down.
Holy fuck. Rachel and Chloe, where are you guys? We're at the temp. What the fuck? What the fuck is going on tonight?
This must be hard for you too, Mr. Amber.
It could be far worse. My biggest fear is that Rachel will try to meet Sarah. I dreaded it.
So that's why you never told her?
You have no idea what pain Sarah's caused. Her addiction has led her to do terrible things. I don't want Rachel to go through any of that.
I don't understand. Are you afraid that Sarah would do something to Rachel?
I don't think she would deliberately harm anyone. But addicts can cause tremendous harm without meaning to.
Yeah. Rachel's not a baby anymore.
Listen to me. Sarah brought criminals and drug dealers into our home. She put Rachel in serious danger just to chase her habit.
Do you think Sarah is involved with any of the drug dealers around here?
It wouldn't surprise me if she were. That's who she is. Chloe, I believe Rachel trusts you more than anyone else right now.
Is this where you ask me to manipulate Rachel into doing what you want?
This is where I ask you to do as your conscience dictates. Please, put my daughter's safety first.
That is something I will always do.
She's so young. You are too. But I know you've experienced loss. Protect her from that. Please.
I'll do what I can. I care about her too, you know?
I know.
Thank you. You're lucky you're a DA, because that's a pretty expensive table that Rachel trashed there. Look at this shit.
Holy shit. Rachel completely destroyed that table. I can't believe I was feeling goofy enough to draw that just a few hours ago. Hey, Mrs. Amber.
I think it's Rose at this point, considering everything.
No.
Okay. Rose. Do you need any help with anything?
That's very kind of you. Could you get out the broom for me? It's in the breezeway. Door to the left of the fridge.
Absolutely. Wait, there was a shirt there. Hold the phone.
Hey. Cool graphic. Rachel was really getting rid of this.
That's right. Take it.
Mrs. Amber, could I have this?
Oh, sure, Chloe. Rachel was going to give it away anyhow.
Thanks.
Were you able to find the broom?
She sounds so fucking depressed right now.
Here you go.
Thank you.
Holy shit.
I'm really quite glad that you're here.
I'm glad too.
You've had to cope with much worse, I know. I'm grateful Rachel has someone as strong as you. How are you doing, Chloe?
How am I doing?
Your generation loves to talk about how awkward different things are. Well, this must be pretty awkward, I'd imagine.
It's fine. Rachel's the one who's really upset.
She has every reason to be. There are many painful things about Rachel's past, including my own role in hiding the truth.
Sarah shouldn't have taken money over seeing her daughter.
You know, I am so thankful to her that she did. It gave me the opportunity to be Rachel's mother. I never knew how much I could love someone until I had Rachel.
But hearing the truth after all these years hurt Rachel more than anything.
I'm not happy with James for the whole way this came out.
You're not happy with James? What about what he did at the Overlook?
It might be hard for you to understand, but after 13 years of marriage, I'm not threatened by what happened.
You're right. I don't understand.
You don't have to worry about me or James. Rachel's the one who needs you right now.
Do you think Sarah is dangerous?
I've never met her, so I don't know. But I'm inclined to trust my husband. His entire life is about keeping people safe. Rachel's extremely fortunate to have him as her father.
You still sound fucking depressed as hell.
It's so weird to look at this now.
Well, I gotta go upstairs and figure out what the fuck. Nope, here comes the copyright. I knew it was inevitable. She's even worse off than Rose is. Holy fuck.
I need some way to show Rachel that I'm here for her. This light needs more light. Wonder what I could find around here to brighten up that nightlight. Rachel's surrounded by so much love, yet she seems so... It makes sense that Rachel needs two signs to contain her awesomeness. I shall call her Lion Crab from now on. Rachel even knows how to make a dinky lamp look cool. We were so close to making our break last night. Now, I don't know. The yin and badass yang of Rachel Amber.
Before all else, be armed.
Rachel has so many inspirations, she can barely keep them all contained. I could get grades like this. I just don't want to.
Why not?
I know something Miss Arcadia doesn't. Weird. Rachel's always made being an A student seem so easy. Almost sad to see all this effort. I think Rachel could use another subject. But which one?
Anatomy.
That's the one.
Oof. Okay, maybe that wasn't what I should have wrote.
At least she'll have something from tonight. Rachel's really into stars. I wonder if it's her way of feeling connected. Hard to believe the show was only a few hours ago. Seems like everything has changed since then.
I could graffiti this too.
Maybe I can make the world a less scary place. On stage, I think Rachel said,
"The corners of the world are mere prologue."
I've heard that Rachel and Nathan hang out sometimes, but it still seems hard to believe. Hey, Rachel. I'm glad you're here, Chloe. Of course.
Jesus, you're fucking depressed. Holy fuck. Alright, well, this is the only thing we haven't checked yet, so... Well, would you look at that? What do you want? I'm leaving the door unlocked in case you don't have your key.
ready for Rachel's light show. Better get her attention first.
This better work. Oh, this is just a giant waste of fucking time.
Hey, check it out. It's beautiful. I thought you might like it. I've always loved stars. Why? You remind us there's so much beauty out there, which we almost never see. Because we're blinded by what's in front of us. Exactly. But then I learned the truth. The stars we're seeing have already been dead. Millions of years. They're all lies. But that doesn't make them any less beautiful, right? I don't know. If they're not even real, then what's the point?
God damn.
Everything. My entire life. My dad. My mom. If I can even call her that anymore.
Duh.
And that other woman. My real mom. She's the biggest lie of all. Trust any of them. I think you're the only one in the world that I can trust. I'll take it. Even if it's only by process of elimination. Good.
God damn your face.
This bracelet my entire life. I never even asked why. Never even thought about it. Somehow, I think I always knew.
No, you didn't.
Even when I didn't know. That my real mother was gone.
People always say this in hindsight. You're full of shit. You didn't know why.
The fact that she's here right now. That she came here. For me. I think I need to see her. Is that wrong?
No.
Of course not. But it might be tough to track her down. Yeah. That's true. Luckily, I've got my secret weapon. But what if we can't find her? It's not like I can ask my dad. No idea where to start.
My drug dealer.
I think I know what to do. I'll call Frank and get him to connect us to her. You do that? We'll give it a shot.
Give me my fucking weed.
Of course, even if we know where she is, we need a way to get to her. Just ask my parents for a ride.
Think you forget I have a truck.
You do?
Yep. In fact, anything you could come up with, I'll handle it.
I know you will. But even if we find her, how will I talk to her? What do I say?
After my dad died, I was worried I wouldn't know how to talk to him anymore. But somehow, when we speak, I always know what to say.
When you speak?
In my dreams.
Son of a bitch, it's dead again.
It's so real. It's almost like it's another part of my life. It used to be the only part that mattered. I've never told anyone about that. Weird, huh?
No.
Rachel?
I was just thinking. Maybe I was wrong before. Who cares if the stars are dead? As long as we can still see them, that means they're real. To us. Right?
Absolutely. What the fuck? Another goddamn acid trip. What the fuck? What the fuck is this? What the hell?
Do it wrong.
That was one time. When are you going to let it go? Remember when we used to work on cars together? Those are...
What the fuck?
Don't you mean my memories? I don't think you remember after...
Touché. Alright, you win. Why don't you go take a look?
You sure?
What the fuck is this improv bullshit? Why the fuck am I wearing that goddamn costume?
What's wrong? Don't you see anything?
Fine. It's... the spark plug.
No, that's not it. I just had that replaced.
Isn't improv supposed to be all about yes and?
Yes and what?
Dad, stop. None of this is real. You're not real. Rachel's family isn't real. This whole thing, it's all just theater.
Well, you know what William Shakespeare said.
Something about the whole world being a stage, so might as well act the fuck out of it.
Nailed it.
But I don't want to be an actor. I just want to be myself.
What the fuck?
Give me a break.
Well, maybe there's a reason we pretend. Maybe the lies we tell each other are less horrible than the truths we keep hidden.
Wow. That's pretty dark, Dad.
Where do you think you get it from? There's my cue.
Dad?
Relax, sweetie. It's all
what the fuck?
Right?
Just a bit of stage magic. Floodlights, sound effects. Chloe, look at me. Look at me, sweetheart. It's going to be okay.
What the fuck? What the hell? Jesus Christ. What the hell? What a bitch. Oh, I finally made it home.
Doesn't seem like Mom. She wouldn't leave a mess like this. Wait. David? That motherfucker. Whatever. I don't have time for this shit. I've gotta help Rachel. Okay. I saw Sarah leaving Frank's RV. You might know how to find her.
I think you're jumping to conclusions.
I'd be totally pissed about Damon's money. I've got to get this exactly right. I can do this.
Price.
Oh, Frank. Eager much?
Where's the money?
Jeez, would you relax? I have it with me, okay? I have a favor to ask you.
You can't be fucking serious.
I need to find that woman from yesterday. Sarah. Frank?
What the hell for?
Something important. Can you help? I'm trying to help a friend. It would mean a whole lot to her.
The girl with you at the mill?
Yeah.
Be in the junkyard in 2 hours. And bring the fucking money.
Sweet. Thanks, man. You're a real...
No. Dick bag.
I guess. What am I getting myself into? Okay, I've got 2 hours to kill. A shower would be fucking amazing.
So what the fuck? water.
Better than nothing.
Did you just water your plant beer? What the fuck?
Is mom playing music?
You've been planning this, haven't you? What the fuck?
Is that David's towel? Where the hell is mine? Okay. Gross. Lots of washcloths. No towel. Awesome pirate towel.
Yeah, you didn't have any luck, did ya? Hey, hair dye.
Can't believe Max and I were so into this shit when we were kids. Wait a minute. Captain Bluebeard's hair dye. Max was going to make me a pirate, but we never got around to it. Ready for the best shower of my life.
Cool. Shower scenes in video games, they go pretty hand in hand at this point. Alright, blue-haired Chloe, good to know. The fuck?
What do I feel like doing on this busy ass day?
I'm just gonna use Rachel's outfit, fuck it. I've never actually found that outfit before when playing this damn game, so. Yep, good enough for me. Let's do it.
One last thing. I need to get Dad's tools so I can fix that truck. Dad's toolbox should be in the garage downstairs. chances I can avoid Mom or David.
Slim to none. Have fun with that.
I'm flipping them over.
Not yet. I told you 3 minutes each side.
They're gonna burn.
Oh, you're the expert now.
I can't stand it.
I'm telling you, it'll make a mess. You know, you don't have to make me breakfast. I'd settle for flowers.
You cook all the time. I want you to have a break at home.
You are one class act, David Madsen.
Huh. Mom actually looks pretty happy right now.
And you being the angsty teen you are gonna hate it. Yeah, I'm not sitting here watching those two dance. That's not gonna happen.
Hey. Who's there?
Son of a bitch.
Hey.
Chloe, your hair. When did... Was this for the play? I heard you perform last night.
Nope. I mean, I did. But this is something different.
None of that matters now. Oh, I am so glad to see you.
Good to see you, Chloe. Coming home was a smart decision.
I'm not staying long. Just picking up some stuff.
Oh. Are you coming home tonight?
Mom, I don't know.
I wish you would tell me what you're up to.
I'm just hanging out with Rachel.
Oh, how is Rachel? I was telling David about the play and you being in it.
I really gotta go.
Listen, wait. Before you go, David has something to say to you.
Yeah.
It won't take but a minute.
Mom.
I think this is the best idea.
You already promised.
Chloe, I've made an agreement with your mother to trust you from now on.
Really? What does that mean?
It means that from today forward, I'm going to take you at your word. So, if you say you haven't been smoking or drinking, then I'll just leave you be. Even though she had pot yesterday.
David. The idea is you should feel comfortable here, Chloe. David's not going to question you, and neither am I.
I'll just do this. Well,
this sounds like it's doomed to fail, but hey, kudos for trying.
Chloe.
What? I really meant it. Good job. Can we be done now?
Wait, one second. Don't go, Chloe. I've been meaning to show you something. Maybe now's a good time. This is my friend Phil Becker. We served in the same unit. Two tours. Becker was killed near the end of our deployment. Roadside IED. We used to joke about all the trouble we were gonna get into once we got back home. But he died. He died, and I didn't. And I think about that fact every damn day. The point is, I've had my share of grief. I know what you're going through. So I guess what I'm saying is, I'm here to do whatever I can to help you get over the loss of your dad.
Please, I'm begging you. Give David a chance, won't you?
Here. Why don't you keep this photo for a little while? Think about what I've said.
Okay. I know that this is gonna have absolutely no consequence on the main game, obviously, but I'm gonna try and make this work. Even though the answer for
so young. And this Phil guy.
Even though if I wanted to keep continuity for the actual first game, I would have had to have completely fucking rejected that offer.
Thank you, David.
Oh, come.
Mom.
I'm just so proud of you both.
Mom, I really need to go.
Be careful out there, Chloe.
I love you, sweetheart.
All right, all right. What the hell? Just gotta grab Dad's toolbox and then get out of here quick. Holy crap. This might actually be helpful for fixing up the truck.
Good to know. Back to the junkyard. Hey, it's the train that hits Chloe in the first game.
Damn it! better. But still needs a bit more love. I can salvage this beat.
David, Chloe, this is David. What the fuck?
Is pretty shaky. I could fix this battery post if I get a good enough grip on it.
Well, actually, let's turn on the radio.
Stan Stanwyck here, and we've got a special treat for all you Sunday Funday listeners out there.
This thing seems
live
pretty dunked up.
Skip Matthews, lead singer of Pisshead, one of the Bay's
hottest new bands. I think I should move on to something
else. Say hi to the fans, Skip.
Hi, fans.
Now, Skip, I understand you work as a security guard at Blackwell Academy. Is that true?
That's true.
The distributor cap looks pretty gross.
And melting their faces off by
I
night.
Need something small to keep the gunk off the cap.
Yeah, something like that.
Fantastic. We're about to play a brand new track. Haven't heard these guys yet. What I want you to do is crank that stereo up as loud as it goes. If anyone complains, what do you tell them, Skip?
It's pretty loose.
Is that rules?
How can I tighten it? Looks like this thing is going to fuck up.
Yeah, well, that's something that players are not going to help with.
Looks like someone tried to patch this thing up sometime before I was born. At this point, I think that ancient duct tape is better than anything I can do. Better leave it be.
Alright, well, with the remainder...
Looks like the serpentine belt could use some help.
Yeah, I'm aware. Just trying to...
Nothing doing.
Son of a bitch.
That should help keep shit distributed.
You dumbass. God damn it.
From whence we came.
Okay, well, I actually should have known the wrench would have been the solution, considering that's what she was fucking working on to start with. Yeah.
Much better. Spark plugs busted. Carbon deposits. Well, of course.
You trying to steal a fucking spark plug from your dad's car?
Please? I need you.
You just got the ride and you're already gonna trash the fucker.
Shit, your hair, it's so badass. I was gonna say hot, but yeah, badass too. Interesting choice in shirt too. Thought you'd like it. It involves fire. Hey, not sure if you saw, but someone moved your truck. No way. Should we check out?
What the fuck?
Hey, Price. Nice wheels.
You're early, Frank. What's the occasion?
It's his fucking bar mitzvah. Frank here's becoming a man. Aren't you, big guy?
What's he doing here?
What do you think? We're not dealing with a couple of dime bags anymore, Chloe. Where's the money?
It's right here. Obviously, I was gonna give it to you. You don't have to be such a dick about it.
Would you just fuck off, Damon?
You heard what happened to Drew, right? Maybe try keeping that in mind when you talk to me.
Don't fucking touch her.
Why is it that chicks think it's okay to hit me? But if I lay a single finger on them, suddenly it's a whole other thing.
Um
says you were asking about a client of his. That true?
I ain't gonna fucking lie to the man. I'm not fucking scared of this little bitch, yeah, but I have no reason to fucking...
I don't see why you should give a shit.
You don't. Maybe I'll show you. See, you two Nancy Drews decided it would be a good idea to call your drug dealer and ask about his business. I didn't go to a fancy academy, but that doesn't strike me as smart. Maybe it was this man's sunny disposition that confused you, but he's got a whole other side to him that I don't think you'd like. Should we let them see it?
We're just talking here.
Okay, then let's talk. I want to know, right now, why you give a shit about this woman?
She's a friend. An old family friend.
This chick doesn't have any family. Or any friends.
That's a lie.
Look, none of this matters. All we care about is that you stop asking questions. Got it?
No. Tell me where she is. Now, Rachel.
Wait a minute. No way.
What the fuck is your problem?
Rachel? As in Rachel Amber? That makes so much sense. This is James Amber's fucking kid.
Damon,
your dad's a real piece of shit.
You're aware. Not sure what that has to do with us.
Me neither. But I'd like to find out. Here's what happens next.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
They're just kids.
No, they're not. This one is the fucking DA's daughter. And right now, she's going to fill me in on what her daddy is up to and how he's connected to that whore everyone's asking about.
Damon, calm down. We're still talking. Everything's still cool. No need to get crazy.
What the fuck? What the fuck are you doing? Ow, no, 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 no. Son of a bitch.
Damon! What the fuck? Chloe, go! Now!
God damn it, Rachel. Why'd you have to fucking do that? Get her in the fucking hospital.
Rachel is going to be all right. The knife damaged her brachial artery, but didn't cut it. She's had a surgery, and now she's resting.
Chloe, fuck.
What happened?
It's my fault. I should have listened to you. Sarah's mixed up somehow with this psycho Damon Merrick.
I know exactly who Damon Merrick is. Start over and tell me everything. Did you and Rachel try to contact Sarah? I'm not going to chastise or blame you, Chloe, but I need the whole story.
Yeah.
So, I got my dealer to meet us, since he knows Sarah.
Frank Bowers.
Yeah, that's right. But Damon showed up with
you should probably stop telling James that, your dealer. Because,
he asked us.
He's kind of the DA.
So interested in Sarah.
And what did you say?
Nothing. Of course.
Is that how it became violent?
No.
When he found out Rachel was the DA's daughter, he wanted information about you.
And how did he know that I'm her father?
I don't know. Maybe he's seen her before.
What happened next?
Damon had a knife out. We all could see it. But then he said something that pissed Rachel off. And she just grabbed a piece of wood and hit him. And then he stabbed her. I keep thinking that maybe I could have done something, but when he attacked her, I just froze.
It's not your fault.
And Frank held him off so we could get to the truck. I heard a scream, but I don't know what happened. And then we were here.
I appreciate you telling me the truth.
What are you going to do about Damon?
Find out if he is alive. First of all, my department's been after him for some time.
Well,
I was told that if Rachel had arrived only a few minutes later, thank you, Chloe. You saved my world. It will be some time before Rachel wakes up. I promise I'll let you know when she does.
Well, trust me, James. You definitely got dirt on him now. I mean, he stabbed your daughter. Oh, hi.
Steph, how's Drew?
Pretty good. Miss Amber just told me Rachel's going to be okay. I'm really glad.
Yeah.
Well, our room's just down the hall. You should come by.
Okay, sure. Definitely.
Oh. Who the fuck? What the fuck?
I don't think I can sit still any longer. Come on. Not that I have any coins anyway. Oh, man. Jackpot.
She didn't seem to care. Nobody is absolutely gonna notice this shit.
Yes.
What? Don't just eat it right in front of the goddamn desk. Nobody's that way. What the fuck? Oh!
Oh, shit. I know those guys.
This doesn't look like the maternity wing.
There's a sign for the prenatal class.
I can't believe we're finally doing this. I'm so excited.
You're gonna be a good dad.
I guess I'm glad we stole their wine. Frank's business must be booming. Shit. I really hope he's okay. If I want to stay sane, I need to stay busy.
All right, then. Thank you.
Hi. Mr. North?
That's me. And you are?
I'm Chloe.
Here to see Drew?
Yeah. How are things going?
Oh, you know how it is. Ups and downs. Now, Drew's hurt, of course. But I'm between jobs, so got plenty of time to visit. You know?
Yeah.
Hold on. You said you were Chloe. Mikey's mentioned you a few times now. I have a question maybe you can answer.
Oh, boy.
Sure.
Both of those boys have been acting a little, well...
Uh-oh.
Guilty lately. Yeah, I've been spending most of my time looking for work. I'm worried I missed something important. Do you know if anything's going on with them?
You should probably ask Drew. I don't really know any details. I do know that whatever it is, they did it because they wanted to help you.
Thanks, Chloe. I know they've been trying to help me out, money-wise. We're a family, you know? We deal with things together. Oh, excuse me.
Hey.
You made it.
Oh. Hey, Chloe.
Hey, Drew. So, what have you been doing all day?
Not much. Homework. Hanging out with my dad. Dealing with the dumb jokes about the plate in my leg.
Sorry to hear it.
It's all good.
Love the hair, by the way.
Pretty cool.
I bet you'd look cool with a little color.
Yeah? I'll have to think about it. Maybe something red? Hey, any news about Rachel? Her mom seemed hopeful.
Yeah, she's gonna live.
Stable.
Until Mr. Jefferson gets involved.
You'll think I'm joking when I tell you, but I'm not.
What happened?
She got stabbed in the arm by demon fucking Merrick.
Seriously? It wasn't because of me, was it?
No, not at all. If anything, I should have thought about what happened to you before getting Rachel involved.
That's crazy. Fuck that guy.
I wish I could get my hands on him.
Drew, chill out, okay?
I'm headed out. Everything okay in here?
Yep.
Yeah.
Don't have too much fun now. Try to keep it appropriate for the hospital.
Bye, Dad.
See ya, Pops.
Man. Maybe I shouldn't have mentioned Damon.
Nah, you should have.
Rachel's gonna be up soon. Should probably head over when I'm ready. Ooh, I want to eat that right now.
Hey. Sorry for leaving it there. It's nice of you to come by.
Feel better. I mean, no pressure. I know it's gonna take a while.
You know what? I'm kind of tired.
Oh, right. I'll leave you alone.
I'm not gonna take his goddamn pudding. That would be such a dick fucking move.
Drew's been in a lot of pain today.
I think the football team needs thicker helmets. Yep. Definitely too many concussions.
You missed the worst bio test ever. Save me some painkillers. What the fuck?
Drew's been in a lot of pain today.
I wonder if Drew will ever play again. Look at that. Wells being nice for a change. All right. I'm gonna head out.
It was really great to see you, Chloe.
Agreed. Don't be a stranger, okay?
Yeah.
Tell Rachel we're rooting for her.
You bet.
Oh, wait, that fucking... Just what air out quality? What the fuck?
Those guys look exhausted.
You mean it's controlled? No, it's completely out. It extinguished itself.
I'm glad that you're here.
Me too, Rachel.
Holy fuck, she looks in rough shape.
Shh. The pain will pass. Chloe's here. You want me to stay?
No. I'll be okay. Thanks, Dad.
Oh. Come back in a little while.
guardian angel. I saw Steph earlier. She says hey. Steph's so cute, but not as cute as you.
Oof.
Stop. I mean, Rachel, I'm sorry. What? What for? You're here because of me. Because I choked back there in the junkyard. What? Shut up. You were so fierce and I just froze. God, I fucked it up. I'm so sorry. And you saved my life. You saved my life. Just don't do that again. Play the damsel in distress. You got it. No. Attack a psycho with a 2x4. That was crazy. News flash, Chloe. I'm a little crazy. Crazy hot. Happy that your dad's here. I mean, I'm still mad at him for everything he's done. But it felt so good to lean on him. He's my dad, you know? I felt completely safe. Like on Mount Hood. Would you do something for me?
Yeah.
Sarah. Mom. It's so weird to say. I'm not even sure what she is, honestly. But I think I still want to meet her. I figured you would. I don't even know if she's still in Arcadia Bay. But if she is, will you find her, please?
Absolutely.
Don't. I do.
If for no other reason, because the plot demands it.
Her number. Maybe in his office. Our house key's just under the mat. The code is 0722. To your dad's office? 0722. Yeah. My birthday. I'll find her, Rachel. And then I'll tell her how fucking cool you are. Thank you, Chloe, for everything.
Alright. Got a mission to do. Get to it.
Elliot?
Hey! Wait. Your hair is different.
The hell is Elliot here for?
I like it. It's nice.
Sorry I bailed on seeing the Tempest with you. The whole thing just sort of happened.
No, not a problem at all. So, what's going on with you?
I don't even know where to start. At the moment, I'm here for Rachel.
What? Rachel's here? What happened?
She got stabbed by a psycho.
Oh my god.
Yeah. It was insane.
Holy shit. Are you okay?
I'm fine. She's fine too, by the way.
Are you two in some kind of trouble? You can tell me if you are, you know. I won't judge.
I'll make sure to keep you posted. Right now, I'm here to take care of Rachel.
Chloe. I'm seriously worried about you.
Well, don't be.
I mean, you're hanging out with Rachel Amber a lot lately, right?
So what?
So, obviously, something is going on.
Yeah, we're a couple, Elliot. I know you wanted in, but that's just not gonna happen.
Everything's really okay.
Okay. I trust you. Just remember I'm here, okay? If you suddenly need something.
Thanks. Anyway, see you around.
Yeah. See you around, Chloe.
The fuck are you looking at? What a fucking creep.
Hello?
Oh. How convenient.
I need to search this office for any communication with Sarah that... It's the big one.
The fuck?
James has a file on Frank. I'd love to read this, but I've got to focus on finding Rachel's mom. Best dad. That stuff is all politics and...
Oh, there's something in there. How convenient.
Sweet. The secret key. Now to find the secret lock.
Thanks for again for visiting.
Feel like I've heard that name before. Pro tip. When digging for secrets, try the DA's computer. James sure keeps lots of files on
Gerald him. Scott.
Even if James is trying to protect Rachel from her mother, this seems like a pretty terrible way to act. I guess getting your ass kissed comes with the DA territory.
Secret booze stash.
More sharing.
That's a locked drawer. What's in here? Ho!
What do we have here? I should check the computer, or some of those files laying around. Arcadia Bay's least wanted.
Well, that's Damon Merrick's.
James has a file on Frank. I'd love to read this, but I've got to focus on finding Rachel's mom.
Now, it's a good thing there's a secret drawer.
Welcome to Shadyville.
And a secret phone.
To know who James is talking to on the secret phone of his. It could be about Sarah.
Well, that's Damon Merrick. Damon. That's pretty easy to piece together there.
What were they talking about? Is the girl Damon's talking about Sarah? Whatever is going on, I need to see if Damon knows where Sierra is. But how do I get him to tell me? Shit. What do I say? James actually has this evidence. Don't think Damon James sure keeps lots of files on people.
Crime report. Verbal altercation with the victim. Merrick brandished a fire poker, hitting the victim several times. Ahead before fleeing the scene. Merrick's gloves were recovered. Okay. Well, it's obviously the gloves then.
Shit. Which of these is... If I can figure out how do I destroy a glove? Maybe I can burn it somehow.
That shouldn't be too difficult. There you go. Evidence be gone.
Oof. Better not touch that again.
Fuck me.
Damn. I hope James has something here to tell me who Damon's informant is. So I need to find which of Damon's guide.
Planning supper.
I should search around the office to see if there's any info to help me out.
Okay.
There's no way that Frank is snitching on Damon. But I love learning about his badass loitering charge. I agree to aid the courts on future cases. That could be seen as a little snitchy. This is that freak from the mill. Wonder what Damon would think of his very cooperative comment. Man, this guy's the snitch. He was so cool to me at the mill. Wonder if there's someone else I could pin it on instead.
Yeah, I'm not selling him out. That's just not gonna happen.
Okay. I'm going to accuse one of these guys, I better be sure I'm right.
Well, the right answer would be Thunder. But we're gonna accuse Mr. You Spilled My Beer, bitch. Fuck you.
Payment? Fuck. Here's hoping James already has Damon's money. Sarah sent this. So, this looks like Sarah stopped cashing the checks James sent her. Guess he forgot to mention that during his story last night.
Where the fuck is he hiding this goddamn money?
I wonder if this has anything to do with Damon's stash.
Sure does.
Holy shit. Holy shit. Does James even know what he's doing? Okay, I still have time. Damon's waiting for his money, right? He wouldn't do anything to her.
You'd like to think that.
I need to get there fast.
Chloe?
What the fuck?
Elliot?
Hey!
Elliot, what are you doing here?
What are you doing here? This is Rachel's house, right?
Why do you care?
Did you really just follow me here? Did you follow me from the hospital?
I did. I'm worried about you.
Oh my god, what a fucking creep.
You're the one acting crazy. You shouldn't be here.
Chloe, what is...
Elliot, put that down. You have no idea what you're dealing with.
And you do? Chloe, what have you gotten yourself into?
You wouldn't understand.
Give me a chance. What the hell are you doing?
I can't talk much about it. It has to do with Rachel's mother. Her real mother.
And that explains you breaking into the DA's home and having this?
Believe it or not, yes.
I'm so sick of you not seeing who Rachel really is.
Oh my god, you need to shut
when
the fuck
you
up.
What she's doing to you.
Elliot, just take a step back.
No. You need to listen to me. What has your relationship with her gotten you?
You don't know what you're talking about.
First night you hang out, what happens? You end up in a fight.
She wasn't even there until I fucking... What?
You don't know what you're talking about. Rachel saved my ass.
I'm sure that's how it seemed to you.
No, that's absolutely how that was.
Bad.
The next day she convinces you to skip school. Magically, she barely gets in trouble.
and you get suspended.
Rachel was there for me. She did everything she could to protect me.
I guess it wasn't enough, huh?
You don't understand. You weren't there.
Was she protecting you when she made you take part in a play you didn't want to be in?
God, look. I'm sorry I ditched you for the play, but...
This isn't about that.
Seriously, man. You need to shut the fuck up before...
I've been quiet long enough.
Look, you're a fucking weirdo.
And I don't mean on stage. She's fake. You're real. And I hate to see her manipulate you like this.
You're just saying that because you want in my fucking pants, and you need to fuck off, you freak.
A high school dropout, hanging out with criminals and breaking into houses. It's crazy. It just as easily could have been you in that hospital today. If that ever happened.
What the fuck?
Dude, you know you sound a little stalkerish right now.
Stalking is defined as repeated unwanted interactions. How long have my interactions been unwanted?
The fact that you know that definition right off the top of your head.
Not Rachel. It's time you saw the truth.
Kinda proves my point.
It means you're going to stop thinking about Rachel and pay attention to me now, for once.
Elliot, please. I know you're upset. But...
I'm not upset! I'm trying to help you.
Elliot's gone full. I need to get the police to come without tipping him off.
Who was there for you? When Max left? When your dad died? No one else gave a shit about you except for me. We have a lot to talk about. And I don't care how long it takes. We're not leaving until you see that I'm right.
Oh, boy.
All right, Elliot. You want to talk so bad? Let's talk.
What's really going on here? You can tell me.
This motherfucking weirdo.
You mean here? Specifically? Like, the Amber House?
I'm talking about your situation. Rachel is dangerous. You need to realize that.
You're right, Elliot. I didn't want to admit it before, but it's true. My life is in danger.
Thank you, Chloe. All I want is to help you. I'm glad you can finally see that.
You're right. I do need help. I need help immediately.
Hey, it's okay. I'm not going anywhere.
I'm attempting to move on, but it feels like I'm being blocked against my will.
It takes a lot of guts to tell me all this. And... I want you to
know. What a fucking creep. Get the fuck out of my way.
Always be there for you. No matter what.
It's the police.
Okay, don't panic. I'm sure they'll just want to ask us why we're here.
What do we do?
I'll talk to them.
There's nothing to be concerned about.
Thank you, Elliot. You're a great friend.
And alarm. God, that fucking kid's weird. Copyright. Holy fuck.
So much destruction. All because Rachel got angry at her dad, who's been lying to her all her life. And he's still lying.
Hey, being a dad's tough.
No.
That doesn't justify what he's done.
I'm just saying, I'd probably do anything to keep you safe.
Hey, Dad?
Yeah?
Did you ever lie to me? I don't mean telling me that ashtray I made for Mom wasn't a piece of crap. I mean, like, really lied. About something that might hurt me to know.
What do you think?
I suppose everyone lies about big things. I mean, the stuff Mom doesn't know about me. So you probably lied too.
Would you love me less?
Not.
You sound pretty sure, sweetheart. You were pretty sure Mom would never fall in love with someone like David, too. Are you really ready to hear the answer to your question?
Ready as I'll ever be.
Problem is, I'm dead. So how am I supposed to tell you anything?
Well, that's not a lot of help. That didn't really amount to shit.
I wish you told me when you could have.
You don't like the perfect relationship we had?
I wish you'd lived long enough for us to fuck it up. No word. My ride, my tunes. Am I seriously going in to face Damon Merrick? All for Rachel. Crazy.
Hella crazy.
Ew.
You're dead.
You don't want me to go?
No. I like the company. Besides, you don't want to miss this. Things are about to get real.
Boy. Yeah, sure is.
Frank? Frank! I'll get you help, Frank. But first, I've gotta help Rachel's mom.
Fantastic.
Where the hell is Sarah? Where's the homicidal drug dealer, Spooky Deerhead?
You gotta believe me, I'm not a goddamn snitch. Who the fuck told you that? Oof.
Knife might not be a bad idea. Never thought I'd have to say that. Glad to see the bone made it. No more beer, no more time. I've got to keep moving.
No.
Everything's going to be just fine. Just a little longer, and all your troubles are going bye-bye.
What the fuck?
I just want to meet my daughter. Can't you understand why does
your daughter? Jesus. So that's what he's worried about. He can't let the public know the mother of his daughter is some junkie.
I just want to see her. You don't have to.
Shut up. James Amber wants you out of the picture. So that's what's going to happen.
This is so messed up.
After all, no one believes a junkie.
No.
He said you've been sober a year. Respect. It's hard to kick this shit.
What the fuck?
You can do this.
Damon.
What the hell are you doing here?
Got your money right here. The money James owes you.
How the fuck do you...
Run!
No one has to know. Just let her go, and I won't say...
You're a prick.
No!
Talking's over.
Leave her.
Shut up. What the fuck? You boosted the DA's shit? Got my money? Burned the evidence? All that?
I'm just trying to help.
Jesus fucking Christ.
I said shut the fuck up!
No.
Go to your fucking happy place.
Run.
Let this be a lesson, kid. Make good life choices, or you'll end up like her. Now, what do I do with...
Damon!
Holy shit, he's fucked.
I fucked you up good, didn't I? Guess you really don't know when to quit. Glad to see you back on your feet.
Chloe.
Frank.
You don't really want to do this again, do you? Okay. Then I don't want to do this again. Come on, man. Fuck you.
What a prick.
Sarah. Rachel. Your daughter.
Holy fuck.
Chloe Price.
Where's Frank? Or Damon?
Your friend, Frank, took care of Damon. You don't need to worry about them right now. Sit.
Sarah, are you okay?
We need to talk about what happened.
I am so, so sorry.
Rachel can never know.
What the fuck?
I think you need help. Let me call someone, or something.
I need you to listen. What James did, hiring that thug, shooting me up with...
He's a piece of shit, and I promise that
Rachel can never know.
That's bullshit, Sarah.
You're not listening.
Rachel deserves to know what happened to you.
No, she doesn't. Rachel deserves a loving father. A father who cares for her.
James is a liar.
James is a desperate man who loves his daughter. And she loves him. Tell her what happened here. And you'll take that away from her. Forever.
Don't you think the truth matters more?
The truth? What's so great about the truth, Chloe?
Why are you saying all this?
Because James is right. He's taken something from me that I might not ever get back. But he's right. I'm broken.
Everybody's broken, Sarah.
Oh? Does everybody abandon their own child for 15 years? Does everybody take money to stay away?
You're here now. That's what matters.
What do you...
I know Rachel needs you. I know loss. I lost my father 2 years ago.
How?
Car accident. He was picking up my mother from the grocery store, and a truck ran a red light, and that was it.
I'm sorry. You don't know what this is to me. Every pain, every fear, gone. No more sadness.
Would you stop with the bullshit?
Why would anyone not want to feel that way? Ever.
I don't know anything about addiction, but I know what it's like to be needed by someone. It gives you strength you never knew you had. Rachel needs you.
Rachel needs her family.
I recognize I might not know what the fuck I'm talking about here, but I wish you could know how amazing Rachel is.
I know.
She's fearless. She's brilliant and talented. And she feels so much. She's so strong.
She's had a good life. Raised in a loving home, given opportunities I could never give her.
At least talk to her. She's felt like something's been missing her whole life. She told me so. That something was you.
She didn't miss anything. She has a perfect family.
I used to think my dad was perfect.
It's a big load of bullshit.
I realize he was probably just as messed up as everyone. And it doesn't make me love him any less.
That's a nice thought. What Rachel needs, though, is not to have her father taken away from her.
He doesn't deserve...
It's not about James. It's not about me, and it's not about you. It's about Rachel. Tell her what James did, and you'll be killing him for her. You understand that, don't you? You lost your father. Do you really want to put Rachel through that?
The worst mistake you ever made was giving Rachel up. That's what you said in your letter to her.
You read that.
You don't have to make the same mistake twice.
Nothing can change the mistakes I made. I'll never get to be Rachel's mother. Not really. But there's one thing I can still do for her. The only thing I can do. Let me give her the father she deserves. The one who raised her, protected her. The one who loves her more than anything.
No.
Do whatever you want, Chloe. You have the power. What you have to decide is whether you're going to protect Rachel or cause her even more hurt. So please, tell her I was never here. Let her have what peace she can. without me.
Wait. Don't go, Sarah.
I'm done here. Goodbye, Chloe.
Fuck's sake.
Hello?
Hi, Chloe. Rachel's just fallen asleep.
I know she'll be thrilled to see you when she wakes up. Maybe come back a little later.
Hey.
Duff.
Go back to sleep.
Can I talk to Chloe alone for a minute?
Oh boy.
Okay, sweetie. We'll be right outside.
How are you feeling? Like I got stabbed? Doc says it'd be a sick scar. Maybe a tattoo.
Holy shit.
Fuck yeah. We never actually escaped. Did we? We've got time. All the time in the world. So. How did everything go? Rachel, I've got to tell you something. What's wrong? I failed you. I couldn't find her. I'm so sorry. Funny, you seem so confident. I really thought you'd find her.
Yeah. Me too.
Maybe we can try tomorrow. Maybe she hasn't left town yet. Of course. I know. Wherever she is, she loves you very much. How do you know that? Because why should she be any different from the rest of us?
Yeah, I could not destroy her family on the possibility that maybe. But it's pretty obvious by the fact that Damon's not in the next game and Frank is that clearly Damon's dead. So, good. Yeah, fuck you, you fucking creep. Get the hell out of here. She's probably dead too, because she hangs out with Nathan and she's not in the next game either. So either she graduated or she was one of his drugged up victims. Yeah, I don't think I got the outcome where Sarah shows up. Oh well. It's not a necessity. If only this happy ending wasn't a complete mirage for the obvious fact that, Rachel's dead. But yeah, That'll be it for this game. That's apparently the only choice that mattered. Yeah. They couldn't leave it out. Fucking dickhead. Alrighty, well, until next time. Peace.